Welcome to the Fountain Elms Library. Going along with the Christmas tree theme, we have a tabletop tree here. These were popularized in 1848 when the London Illustrated News published an image of Queen Victoria and Prince Albert standing around their own tabletop tree. When the public saw that the royals were partaking in a German tradition, they quickly decided to follow suit, and those customs trickled down to Americans as well. So sharing the table with the tabletop tree is a putzsatz. The term putz is derived from the German verb putzen, which means to put or place or adorn. It is, in essence, a miniature rendering of a farm or a village. It was a great way to get children involved in the holidays, as they would often go outdoors and search for stones and moss and sticks to place into the display. So over here on this side table and also on the mantle, you will see some Christmas cards from the Munson-Williams Proctor collection. In the 1860s and 70s, the Europeans began to mass produce Christmas cards, and they eventually reached the American market. And you'll see in these cards here, we have some typical imagery of Santa and holly. But in Victorian times, there were very few pieces of true Christmas iconography. Basically, if something spurred conversation, it was considered festive. Which leads me to some of the Christmas cards featured in this fire screen over here. Some of these cards feature outlandish themes that we would never associate with Christmas today. You'll see we have clowns, lobsters, an unfortunate dead bird, a man shaped like a beet. There's a figgy pudding fellow with implements stuck in his face. And all of these were just hilarious at the time. So this fire screen here was actually a project that I created based on the 1883 Art Interchange magazine. There was an article mentioning different projects that one could make with all of the Christmas cards that you receive. Since we are in the throes of a pandemic, it is important to place it in the context of history. In the early 20th century, tuberculosis was the leading cause of death in the United States. Sanatoriums proved relatively successful, but funding was scarce. In 1907, a woman named Emily Bissell started a campaign called Christmas Seals. Postage stamps were created with Christmas motifs. They were sold at the post office for a penny apiece, and the funds went towards the tuberculosis initiative. It was wildly successful, as was a previous campaign in Denmark, and has continued throughout the years. So you'll see on the desk here, we have facsimiles of those postage stamps ranging from 1907 through World War I. That concludes the library. Thanks for watching and happy holidays.